We've been learning a lot of derivative rules, and there's a few obscure ones that we need to cover right now, and that is the derivatives of the inverse trig functions. Let's just take a step back for a second. Inverse functions, very common in math. Let's ignore trigonometry for a second. You know y equals x squared and y equals square root of x. Those are inverse functions of each other. And they both have derivative rules. Another famous set, y equals natural log of x and y equals e to the x. Those are inverses of each other, and they both have derivative rules. So the world of trigonometric functions, sine, cosine, tangent, secant, cosecant, cotangent, they also all have derivatives, and so they've got derivative rules. I'll bet your mind is racing and you're a little bit worried about memorization. This is why your mind is worried about memorization of derivative rules, because you remember you once learned all six of these trig functions have these derivatives. So now you're thinking, holy cow, am I going to have to learn six more inverse derivative rules? Or sorry, inverse trig function derivative rules? Well, the good news is, no, you're only going to need to learn two. Let's take a look. In this course and on the AP test, there's going to be a gentleman's agreement that we're only going to focus on arc sine of x and arc tangent of x. Now, in theory, you would be responsible for learning those other four, but in practice, you don't need to do that. These are the only two that will show up during our course, and throughout the history of the AP test, those are the only two that have ever shown up on the AP test. Before we look at that rule, let's just make sure we realize these are living, breathing functions. So arc sine would look like that, and that would be arc tangent. For the purposes of this, let's not get into how these graphs are generated. It's just enough to know right now that this thing is all curvy. This thing is all curvy, so they must have slopes, and thus they must have derivatives. So here's how it's going to go. Arc sine of x, you're simply going to follow this rule, which says, hey, you see that x, whatever was in there? Let's square it. And if there was a ninja, multiply by the ninja. For arctangent, we would say, hey, whatever was in there, square it. So notice these, and of course, if there's a ninja, multiply by the ninja. We will cover that. Now, I've written these informally. We're going to talk about this more formal definition down here in a moment. But here's a little memory aid that I think might help you. Sine looks like sin. Sin, most people would say, is a negative thing. So I have a negative sign. And to distort a famous phrase, sin is the root of all evil. So I have a square root. Sin is negative. Sin is the root of all evil. Notice the tangent has the same structure, a one and an x squared, one x squared. But now let's think of getting a tan. If you think about getting a tan, you're probably thinking about being on the beach in some beautiful area by a lake or a ocean. So most people think of getting a tan as a positive thing, thus you use a plus. And getting a tan, there's no evil in getting a tan, so there's no square root. So hopefully that would help you memorize. If you don't like that, then just memorize it. All right, so this is an informal definition. Here's more of a definition of what you would get if you were looking through a textbook. I wrote down that, hey, don't forget the ninja. This is what it looks like in math language. I've got some u, and it could be a function u living inside of arc sine. That u would have a derivative, du dx. So, oh boy, I think I have a mistake. I forgot a square root there. We need a square root on this thing. All right, so arc sine has the derivative 1 over the square root of 1 minus inner guts squared times the derivative of the inner guts. All right, that's been a lot of talking. That can be summed up in, see that? Memorize it. See that? Memorize it. All right, let me show you a few examples. I think just two of them, and then you'll be good to go. All right, on this one, let's see here. All right, so we have arcsine of 3x squared. The inner guts goes right there. The inner guts had a derivative. There's the ninja. And this is totally a fine answer, but let's say you had to rearrange it and match a multiple choice answer. There's always a chance that they might do an eyeball adjustment. This stays in the numerator. This thing, once I square it, looks like that. This is the same thing as that. All right, let's do one more. All right, we have inverse tangent. And instead of inverse tangent of x, it's inverse tangent of cosine. By the way, notice arcsine is the same thing as writing this. Just like here, I wrote it as inverse tangent. We could have written it like that. Anyway, I need that derivative, so I reach into my brain and I say, here's the inner guts. What is that derivative? The inner guts get squared, positive because it's tangent, no square root because it's tangent. The inner guts has a derivative. Don't forget that little negative. Totally correct answer. If I wanted to rearrange it to make it look different, it could look like that. All right, two new derivative rules. That's it.